It's possible to customize the fonts and colors of your cards. To do so, click the Edit button on the bottom left, and then click the Cards button up the top. On the right-hand side, we can see a preview of what the front of the card looks like, and a preview of what the back of the card looks like. And in this particular note type, we have two different cards, one that shows front to back, and one that shows back to front. To customize the appearance of our cards, we use this section over here, the styling section. The styling section uses a type of code called CSS, which is a code used for styling web pages on the internet. It might look a little scary at first, but it's actually pretty straightforward. This information here defines the style of all of our cards. The first line, font family, chooses the font that you will use. So if we change Arial to Times New Roman, for example, we can see that the font over here has changed. When you're editing, please be careful not to remove semicolons and colons and things like that, or Anki will get confused. The next line, font size, controls the size of the text. So if we change it to 40, for example, we can see that everything has become bigger. We can also customize things per field, but we'll get to that later. Text align allows you to control the alignment of the text. You can have center, left, or right. Put that back again. And color and background color control the colors of the card. So we can change black to, for example, red or brown, light blue, and you can also use HTML color codes, which are documented in the manual. The background color, if we change it here, nothing's happened. The reason is that if we look further down, this styling also includes a styling for just the first card. So if we look at the second card, we can see that the background color has changed to red, because any cards that don't have a special definition use the default. So if we want to change the color of this first card, we would change it here. Blue, for example. And so instead of defining red for this one, we could put this back to white. And then we could add a .card2 and put the background color of yellow, for example. And we can see that it's changed for only the second card. This is useful for quickly reminding you of whether you're looking at a front-to-back or back-to-front card. It's also possible to customize the styling for individual fields. So, for example, if you wanted this Alaska to appear in big writing and Juno to appear in little writing, we could do that. To do so, click the Add Field button on the bottom left. Choose the field that you would like to add, and here we have the front, so we want to use front here. And choose the font size and whether you want to put it on the front template or the back. So let's use, for example, Arial Black, and we'll choose a size of 40, and we'll add it to the front here, and click OK. After doing so, Anki has added some styling information around this front field reference here. So anything that is inside, let's break it up to make it a little clearer. There's a little bit of styling information here which says start styling in this style. Then we have the front reference, and then we have this little div part here which says stop styling in the style that we just used. So if we type in extra things like hello, we see that it's also using that styling information. And so you can put multiple fields here if you wanted to. You can also put any kind of styling information in these tags here that's also included here. So for example, if we wanted to make this text red, we'd look and see we've got the color light blue here. So this particular part of information, we want to copy this and put it inside this styling information here. All we have to do is make sure that we leave the semicolons so that Anki doesn't get confused. So if I paste this in and remove the extra text, and let's change this color to red, we can see that this particular field has changed color now without changing the color of the rest of the information here. Also, we've got the field being displayed twice. So if we go up the top and remove the first reference, which was there originally, we now have the front field styled differently to the back. If we now close the card preview screen and return to studying, we can see that our changes are reflected on the study screen. Aside from changing the colors and fonts, you can also add text to your templates to make things clearer. If we go back to Edit and Cards, we can add a prompt, for example. What's the capital city of Alaska? Let's remove these extra spaces to make things a little bit more compact. And add a question mark. If we add it here, it's big. If we add it here, it's small. Let's add it bigger. Now we close, and we can see that this what's the capital city of will appear on all of our cards. So if we answer this one, go to the next one, you can see that the formatting is consistent across cards. One last thing to point out is how Anki handles new lines. Because the cards are formatted in the same way that web pages are, simply putting a new line in the template doesn't put a new line on your card. So if I type hello and put an enter world, we see that these two lines are actually appearing next to each other. To force a new line to appear, we need to add a special code, which stands for a line break. We type angle brackets, BR, and then angle brackets again. And then we can see that hello world is displayed on two lines on the card.